When did you eventually like hurt your knee?
Well, I went to UCSB and I was shooting a what was it, a calendar?
Transworld or
Transworld.
Something.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You, once again, you guys know, you know, all the information. So I went out there and was shooting that Transworld calendar, mm-hmm. and I had done a backside lip slide down a 5-stair, and I felt pretty good about that.
Mm.
And you know the deal. You always try to get a backup photo because you know, or is it going to, what is it going to look like? Is it going to work? Whatever.
And you're just feeling it.
Yeah. And you're out there, you're starting to feel it.
Mm-hmm.
So I tried to ollie off like 8 stairs and over this wall that extended out on the right hand side. And it was right when the really thin, popsicle boards came out. Oh. And, I wasn't going fast enough. And the edge of the board hit the edge of the wall. Not enough for me even to realize the board left my feet.
Oh, really?
So I kind of extended my front foot, came down, and the knee just buckled.
Because this isn't even like, I mean, it was big, but it wasn't even like that big.
It wasn't that big a deal.
Right.
It really wasn't.
Like you were just going to go ollie, get a photo.
And to be honest, it kind of stunk as a spot anyways.
Oh, did
you
it?
You know, so I really kind of choked it multiple ways that time.
And so did you just land stiff-legged?
Stiff-legged, and I yelled out with a yell that says like, party's over, boys.
Dude.
Damn.
What actually ended up happening to your knee?
I blew out probably like 3 or 4 tendons and dislocated the cartilage to the bottom of my knee. It was just a complete blown deal.
Really?
Yeah, it was a party closer.
Did Paul have insurance back then for you guys? Or?
They did. Mm-hmm. You know, but, you know, I think at the end of the day, it was a little bit of like the wires getting crossed. And, you know, I eventually, you know, filed a workers' compensation claim.
Which that in turn, everybody thought that you sued Powell.
That's correct.
Right.
Which was completely incorrect. And the interesting thing is like it was before a lot of social media and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And because I'm in the Bermuda Triangle.
Yeah.
So I don't really get to say what I really wanted to say immediately when I wanted to say it.
Right.
So a lot of, you know, publicity stuff, you know, so it was kind of a tough spot.
Well, that was a rumor that, I mean, I grew up with and I heard was like, oh, Frankie Hill sued Powell because he was suing them because they were making him do all this stuff or, you know, like whatever.
That's the rumor mill of skateboarding.
Exactly. Yeah. But a workers' comp thing is the company puts money into, it's a government run system, right? It's like the government runs this workers' comp.
I filed a claim with workers' compensation. They approved it. I went back to college. I got my knee surgery and, you know, eventually got back on track.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it was just like, you know, it was a tough situation. You know, it was a bad injury. So,
yeah, no, for sure. And because you didn't go get it fixed right away, right?
I did go to the doctors and I did get an MRI and the doctors did say, yeah, you know, it's shot. And I think the wires were crossed, you know, after that.
How so?
For going back, you know, I didn't get a second appointment.
So. Oh, shit. Oh. So did you ever get the surgery?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. Okay, I filed the workers' comp claim and then I got the surgery.
How much later was the surgery?
I think it took about 2.5 years or so.
Oh, wow.
It's a long time. And you continued skating on it too, right?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, I continued to skate on it. I kind of did my, you know, I did the chaos video.
I was going
to
say chaos.
Was kind of my, you know.
Swan song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was. You know, I was trying double flip, varial down the 6.
Mm-hmm.
And the knee was starting to. So that's why you see me in the video rubbing my leg. And I'm like, maybe I should just try 360 double.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because I'm like, I'm closing out here, boys. Oh. I need to get something before.
Oh, man.
So then I got lucky and got that one in there. So,
man, I loved Powell Skate Zone, funnest park in the world.
Correct.
We'll talk about that in a minute because I went up there. That was the closest skate park to me. I had to drive up to Santa Barbara or get somebody to drive to go skate.
Nice.
You know?
That was a great park.
Oh my God, I loved it. So, do you think like that the rumor mill of skateboarding and all that stuff? Did that affect? I mean, I'm sure you heard it. I'm sure that how do I tell these people that I didn't do that?
Yeah. I mean, it was an absolute I mean, it didn't feel great. That's for sure. So it kind of was a little bit of insult to injury.
Right.
You know, being somebody that, I mean, all I was about the tricks.
Yeah.
I wasn't a real big tucker. You know, I was about the tricks, you know, so it hurt.
Yeah. Especially like your fellow skaters, like believing this Rumorville thing that you can't defend at the time.
Yeah, it was tough.
Yeah.
And, you know, eventually, you know, Nate Sherwood came out with a documentary on me. Mm-hmm. And that turned a lot of things around. At the same time, social media was really coming alive.
Yeah.
With, you know, people putting faces and names to their stuff. So then people had to back up what they were saying. You know, I mean, geez, dude, it was like kind of hectic for a while.
Yeah. I could imagine because like it just made you look bad.
Yeah, it didn't make me look good.
For sure. And you can't even skate either.
Right.
That's right.
Yeah.
So that's like, the theory. I couldn't skate. And if I could have skated, then I could have skated and then I could have stuck my beak back in and been like, hey, boys, and we'll, you know, hello. You know, like, so I'm kind of like Mr. Quiet Mouse just getting hammered on.
Yeah, well, it's funny because like that's what like the Rumorville, and then it's Rumorville, and then it becomes a game of telephone, right? Because it's like, oh, he sued Powell. Oh, he sued the school. Oh, he sued this. Like, it just becomes this like washed, like this weird washing machine, you know?
Yeah.
So it's really bizarre.
Yeah, and trust me, none of that really affected my mental state, but you know, it kept driving me. I'll be back eventually.
When you filed your workers' comp claim and this rumor is going around, like, did you ever speak to like George or any of those guys about it? Like, hey, dude, like, people are saying I sued you guys.
Well, I never really reported it back. You know, in that fashion, but I did get some information that some of the information just didn't get to where it needed to go.
Mm.
So, and it took me a long time, you know, to get that information, but I did eventually get that information, and that's the way it went. I shouldn't have quit.
Right.
You know, it was tough for me because I just didn't want to be the guy over there just clapping for other people. I was about, you know, the competition, you know.
And yeah.
So I eventually walked. I've never quit in anything in my life. You know what I mean?
Damn. And then did you immediately go to Consolidated?
I did just for a couple of months, but then I shut it down because I knew the knee was blown and I felt bad even, you know, accepting, you know, any money from them.
Like milking it.
Yeah, I liked, you know, they were my friends on the team and yeah, I couldn't contribute. So I was like, this is not going to, I can't live with this myself. So.
Right. Was the quitting the Powell though? I mean, you're quitting Powell, but you're getting on another company. Mm-hmm. I mean, was there like other things going on that you just didn't feel like you could stay at Powell?
No.
No.
No, it was all because I was injured.
Yeah, that's it, huh?
That's yeah. Why Stacy left around that same time too, right?
So. I believe he did. You know, and I think at the end of the day, it was a little bit of a monetary situation. I live somewhere. I had to pay rent.
Right.
So I was like, oh, I'll get on this other team. I, you know, maybe I can squeeze out a little bit of stuff.
Mm.
But then after a couple of months, I'm like, I can't squeeze out anything.
Because the Powell checks are probably going down and down and down.
They were at that time too.
Yeah.
After you hurt yourself, were like Todd or any of those dudes checking up on you? Like,
well, I believe Todd left Powell,
did
he? You know, around that same time too. So things were changing pretty dramatically around that time.
Todd Hastings.
So. Yeah.
Yeah. Huh. It's so interesting, man, these roads of skateboarding that take you places, you know? It's like where you go down so many different paths and you wonder, oh, if I went down this path, what could have been different?
Correct.
You know, it's such a weird thing.
Where is that like button, right? Is it right here or right here?
Just a little scroll coming down the bottom.
It's
subscribe
over to it's on your left.
Right?
No,
on left.
Your left.
Hey,
yeah,
hit that button right there.
Right there.
Right there.
Yeah,
the like button's kind of like in the right middle there. It's like we're kind of like
oh, it's there. Like right here.
Kind of
like
yeah,
right there.
The subscribe's like over to the left.
It's like right over there. All right.